Hey there, everyone. It's your friends from the Prime Real Estate team. Tony, that's me. And we got Megan on the screen and Daniel. And of course, it is the start of the month. We're at November the, it's the 4th right now. So we're a couple days behind just because, you know, things get kind of busy. But we're here, of course, to give you the statistical report for what happened last month, October, in real estate here in Greater Victoria. So just throwing some quick numbers around here, guys, as I always do. I just want to show you our sales were down again. You may have read this in the news, 35.6%, remembering that we're comparing to what was a strong October last year. 480 sales, by the way, is the, I believe that's the seventh lowest in 30-year record. So it doesn't mean it's the worst, guys. You know, some people are saying it's a really soft market. There were other markets that were softer, right? The inventory level, we are up 111%. So we're up over close to 2,200 listings right now, which is good. It's more choice. Again, though, it's low and it's something like fifth or sixth lowest in history too. So we're not at the point right now where there's tons of stuff for people to see. Prices ended up, as you can see on the screen there, average price for a single family home in Greater Victoria, $1,238,949. This is actually 6.7% below October of last year. But you guys remember, things were starting to pick up, right? Things were starting to pick up the end of the year last year into the first quarter of this year. But things are, you know, most definitely a little softer now than they were because, let's face it, that was a crazy, crazy marketplace, right? Megan, what are you seeing out there?
I'm seeing a little bit more activity with buyers. They're getting a little bit more confident, I'm finding, with interest rates. They're seeing that they're going up. It's known now. And lots of people are kind of like locked in and a little bit more confident and understanding what that means. Mm-hmm. And they're kind of getting a little bit back out there.
I'm with you. It seems like people just, you know, it's a little less uncertainty, right? Mm-hmm. Yeah. Exactly. You've been bumping into things where things are selling quickly, like not everything's sitting around because there are properties out there right now that have been around for 4, 5, 6 months, even. Right. Mm-hmm. But you have bumped into a few like 4-day turnarounds recently, right?
Yeah. A couple condos and I believe a house, obviously kind of a little bit more desirable places, or maybe people have been waiting for a spot in that particular building, but some with some quicker turnaround as well.
Yeah. Yeah. Now, when you see something that sells in 4 days, they're not having to drop their price a bunch.
No.
But it's the ones that have been around a long time, which are dropping price. Daniel, you mentioned All Bay. There's that waterfront property in North Saanich, right?
Yeah, I'm seeing a few that, priced at the peak, came on at the peak and maybe just missed their timing a little bit, right? So now 3-4 months later, you are seeing some pretty substantial price reductions on some of those.
Well, tell our followers here, let's talk about the numbers of that All Bay property, because right now it's 1.9 or something, right? It's less than $2 million. Waterfront, right, in North Saanich.
Yeah, I think it started, my timing might be slightly off, but I want to say in June or July, and I think it started at about 2.7.
Yeah.
Let's come down to 1.9. Pretty attractive, really. I mean, that's quite a price for a waterfront property in Sydney.
So you know what? That's one of those things where it's like, oh my goodness, it was priced at the peak. Because I think it was May, right? Okay. $2.7 million following the market down. There's always a question though, was it even worth 2.7 back at that point? And the answer is probably no, right?
Right.
But right now it looks like a $700,000 or $800,000 price adjustment. To me, it was hard enough to find waterfront at $2 million not that long ago, right?
Almost impossible.
Yeah. So interesting time, folks. And what does it mean moving forward? Well, the demand is still there. Sales numbers, yeah, they're softer. There's no question. Still people buying. We still have people coming into town every single week, not just every month. Every week we have somebody new coming into town. As long as there's more people moving in than moving out, this is what happens. The city can't grow because, of course, we got water on three sides here. So things just continue on. Couple things I do want to bring up. I had a chat with Denise Webster, who's one of our fantastic mortgage brokers. We're having a conversation today, and I've interviewed her, by the way. So if you want to listen to it on CFAX next week, it'll be next Saturday. We're having a conversation about variable rate mortgages. and static payments and trigger rates, all of these interesting things that are going on right now. So be mindful of, maybe check your interest rate. If you're wondering, if you're on the plan where your payment doesn't change, you're going to wonder what's going on with how much principal you're paying down on a monthly basis, because it also can affect your amortization, right? So have a look at your mortgage documents, check with your mortgage person, something that you'll want to know, right? The other thing too is I was on a call with broker managers across British Columbia on Tuesday talking about this upcoming legislation in January about the home buyers, the rescission period. So at some point in time, January the 1st, buyers will have 3 days to change their mind. Right now, almost everything has conditions anyways, you know, subject to financing, building inspection, all that stuff. It's common back to normal times. But if it is an unconditional offer, the buyer has 3 days to change their mind. And if they do, they execute that, exercise that, then they must pay the seller 0.25% of the sale price. So on $1 million, they're going to pay the seller $2,500 for the privilege of backing out. So some really interesting things, but we'll keep you on top of that as we move along. Anything else, guys, for the month of October 2022?
I don't think so.
Why does your background look tropical, Daniel? What is this?
I searched everywhere in this house to try and find something that wasn't really dark, and this is what I found.
Oh my goodness. Well, hey, the change in weather right now, right? So there we go, guys. Sales stats report for October 2022. As always, I'm going to put the information in the email here. If you guys ever have any questions, you want to talk about what's going on out there, or maybe chat about what your plans are, just reach out to us. We love chatting with you. See you soon.
Bye-bye.
Bye.